Hello and welcome back to Football Tactics and Glory and Manchester's journey to the Premier League. My name is Rio, and in last episode we lost 2-1 to Albuquerque in a game where it simultaneously felt like we should have lost by more, but also we were very close to actually coming out with tie. So, bit of a strange game, but for today's game we are taking on Birmingham, who we actually beat to clinch our rise to the second league last season. Now, Birmingham is behind us in the standings, and we don't particularly want them to catch up. So, if we can pull off another victory against them, that would be extremely helpful. Now, looking at this team, yeah, they are not well set up for beating us, pretty much. Gonna bring over Thacker so we have the easy pass there, but Paisley isn't the strongest defending midfielder. We've got Calvert right there to exploit that weakness. We do have to contend with Worley. I think we will. Does anyone have Rainbow Faint? Michaels has Rainbow Faint. So we're going to move our defense there. I think that is good for the moment. I'm hoping things go well here. Why? That's a bit strange. So they have their defending midfielder on the bench. And he's not tired, so why is he there? I mean, he's age 33. He's gonna be retiring fairly soon. But here we go, Manchester versus Birmingham. And this is the very first game in our newly built stadium. They spent the last week building it up. Well, actually, we had an away game, so we can say that it was the last 2 weeks. But here we go. We're going to be kicking off. And look at all the fans. And we do get it over to Calvert. And we're going to have a very easy break-in, because Will and Ojeda don't have the ability to stop us. We could go precision shot. We're going to go for the power shot, and it is saved by Dennison. So Roman comes over. Dennison's not got the best control, so we're going to just go with Olsen in there and try and get this. We've been a bit unlucky when it's come to corners recently. I think early in the season we were able to get a lot of them, but now... Oh, wow, Olsen kept the middle. And Calvert kept the back, and I think Will managed to head it out of the way. And Olsen comes out to take it from Ojeda, but he's probably not going to be able to keep it from Will. Bring over Yancey. I guess... I'm surprised they can press from there, but it's an easy takeaway from Will. And Will passes to Paisley. Okay, up comes Thacker. Now, I could go for the slide tackle and then potentially get it into Calvert or Olsen, but either one's going to be intercepted by Will. That's worth a shot. And we get the slide tackle here. Yeah, that's going... We're going to try and get it past Will. We do. And Olsen has... Oh, no. Almost. That there. And cannon shot. And we've got a level 2 cannon shot here. Not that we needed the second level. Olsen gives Manchester the lead. He's not getting the headers, but, you know, he's still finding a way to score. And that puts us up 1-0. Yancey passes to Worley. Worley moves over, and yeah, he's doesn't have the issue with the center defender there. He's kicked away to Doss. Now Doss could try and pass it over to Thacker or to Bowers. Could move out and then get the pass over, or could do a lofted pass to Roman. And that's what we're going to try. It didn't work out, but at least we're closer Yeah, it's Steph. Now, Yancey can't press from there, and no one has a slide tackle, so I think we're just going to hold this with Thacker and try to counterattack on the next possession. Oh, Yancey can press from there. Never mind. And over comes Siegel. And Siegel will also press. So who's coming up? Ramsey. Ramsey's coming up. Wow. I did not expect that. How did he not take that away? Ojeda gets it. Unfortunately, Calvert's not great on defense, and he's not able to take it away. And we're not going to the aggressive tackle, but we are going to take it away and try and keep it from Will. That's successful. Now Ojeda. This is a risky tackle. Oh, nope. They've got a motivated player. And Will's got it. Calvert is very tired. We've been asking him to do a lot recently. And it's taking a toll on him. I guess Thacker comes over. Yeah, we don't have a great situation here. Olsen's going to move back out. Because at the moment, we are in an offsides trap with Calvert. And the pass gets past Shatter, but doesn't get to Worley. Worley comes over and takes it. That control is concern. Nope, that's not what I meant. Sometimes my mouse has been doing that recently. And Shatter can't take it away either. But he's gonna try again, and he does get it this time. Thankfully, Worley's not the best on defense, but that didn't stop him. Worley's got it. Is he going to break in? No, he's going to move back and go for the shot. And it gets by one, and it gets by Hodges, too! Birmingham ties the game. I can't believe Hodges couldn't save that. And the lofted pass gets over towards Calvert, but is taken away. Now Olsen's got it. Olsen is going to go for the precision shot, and it's intercepted by Will. And the pass gets to Paisley. Paisley passes to Yancey, and Yancey with the final move moves past Thacker. Never mind, not the final move. What's his move now? And gets by Bowers as well. What's his plan here? The shot got by Doss, but couldn't get by Childress. So we have a 1-1 tie at halftime. And I really, I can't believe they managed to tie it here. We've got a bit of a sticky situation with Calvert. I mean, Calvert is really good. But I think we have to bring in someone else, and I think that's going to be Fry, because he's got the cannon shot, so if we get him in a good position, we might be able to steal a goal. It's not a perfect situation, but it's the best we've got. Worley gets the ball. Worley moves up and goes for the shot, and Childress kicks it away. So, I guess Shatter will come back for it. Shatter gets it to Thacker with the extra action. Can't really get it to Fry. Oh, again, I'm not meaning to click on those, but at least that one worked out. So Fry's going to hold this one and try and keep it from Ojeda. That does succeed, but no, he's motivated. And Ojeda takes it away from Fry. It's been a while since I think he's been in a game. I think maybe, possibly years. It's possibly been years since we've had Fry in a game. And Ojeda this wall here is very difficult to get past at the moment. I'm gonna move Shedder up. And otherwise, I think Roman will come over so we can at least get a press off on Ojeda. And he passes to Yancey. And Yancey will go with the lofted pass to Worley, and it does get there. So Worley's going for a shot again. Thankfully, other than the goal, which, you know, was unfortunate, Childress has been doing pretty well at getting the ball there. So Shedder gets the ball over to Roman, and we've got Olsen in the box here. Roman passes to Olsen. Olsen puts it away again. His second goal of the game gives Manchester the lead back. And I think I want to stop Worley getting by so easily with that. So I think it might be time for Thacker to come out and also. Not Olsen, Roman to take his place as we try and secure a win here. Yancey gets the ball by both Roman and Bowers. Now Michaels is concerning here. And can't be taken away by Tompkins. The shot gets by both. Apparently that was not the right formation to go with. Thankfully, we could change it. Unfortunately, we've got to deal again. Not what I meant to hit, but that's just how it goes. Fry coming out to the side here. He can't do that. So Fry's just going to hold this one, and we're going to try and keep it from Ojeda again. And he's fouled by Ojeda. How are we going to go about this? I think it might make sense for Fry. Well, that's it. Okay. Yeah. Fry to go there, Roman to go here, Olsen to go here, so that we set up for a cross. And that's what we're going to do. And Olsen puts it away! That's a hat trick for Olsen! Man, this is quite the action-packed game there. And Olsen has been, well, the most active of any of the players on either team. And this one doesn't get to Worley smoothly, but Worley, oh no, overcomes Benedict. And Benedict goes for the shot, and Hodges hasn't been able to save a thing. What is wrong with Hodges? We've gotten nothing from him. Okay, please don't auto-select here, but yeah, not going to be easy. But if we do this to Fry, Fry's going to have some difficulty with the control. That's right. So we're going to move in with Fry, and we're just going for the shot. The unlikely shot here. And can't get by on that. So we're going to have to hope for a counterattack if we're going to be able to pull off the win in this game. Ojeda's going out. What's his plan? He's going to hold this one. Now Fry, the aggressive tackle's not really going to work, so we're going with a press, and Olsen's coming up, and Olsen can't take it. Couldn't take it the first time, but he can take it the second time. I think that's probably going to lead us to a tie, though. Ojeda takes it away. They've got... Okay, we do have five actions left, and the lofted pass is controlled by Michaels. And Michaels goes for the shot, and it's kicked away to Benedict. And Olsen's in. Okay. How do we do this? How do we pull off a last-second move here? If Schroeder takes this, I think he's too far away to get it to Olsen or Fry. So, taking the ball is one action. Moving and swapping with Bowers is another action, and we can probably get it to either Olsen or Fry at that point. But it's all dependent on this tackle. Schroeder takes it away. Now, just to check, yeah. He's going to swap positions. There. And we can potentially get it. And no, Ojeda's strong against it, and that's an interception. That is the end of the game. Manchester and Birmingham tie 3-3. I can't believe Hodges failed to save every single shot that made it to him. Just one save would have gotten us a win there. A very exciting game, but I'm disappointed that we weren't able to come away with a victory. Olsen worked so hard for that. On the brighter note, we do have Childress with an upgrade here. Now he's age 29. We can do level 2 skill training or 2 attribute points in focus. 70% experience. All of these are valuable. All of these are very, very valuable. But I think we're going with the 2 attribute points in focus. And no one else is going to be taking a step there. Okay. Got a decent amount of money, some new fans, but that 3-3 tie. Now let's see. Columbus lost to Nashville 2-1. Madison beat Des Moines. Tampa beat San Jose. San Antonio crushed Providence. Bismarck beat Honolulu and Oklahoma City beat Albuquerque. And now we are down to 9th. A win would have kept us up in the area of San Antonio and Columbus, but unfortunately, that's not what we got. And now we are just above Madison and slightly above Birmingham. We are definitely in the bottom half of the standings. And our next game is against Bismarck, who are now the top team in the league. And I could see why they're the top team in the league. This is not going to be an easy matchup. But we've got 4 more games in the first half of the season. Nope. 6 more games in the first half of the season. I forgot that we're in a bigger league now. So we've got some decent games under our belt, but we're just failing to come through in the moments we need to get that tie against Albuquerque, to get wins against Birmingham and Nashville. But hopefully, we can find those breaks and make them go our way against Bismarck. I hope you join me for the next episode. Leave a like if you like the video. Comment below any thoughts and subscribe for more Football Tactics and Glory. Have a great day and happy gaming.